was from this Peter, that is number 6. Gathering the flock that is forming and uniting it into a genuine Christian community. And with leading the Christian community, pastoral leadership. Gathering, that is a formation, and leading, that is pastoral leadership, shepherding. And it is ultimately aimed at building and promoting community. When we speak about gathering and leading, it is aimed at building and promoting community.
Hindi, mukha mo lang.
So the formation and presiding over the parish as communion and communities is the priest's responsibility.
Itna ako po na.
With an active participation.
Meron kumuha dun eh.
You cannot have a communion and communities without priest. It's always the responsibility of the priest. Look at that. Paris priest at kanya na nasama mga pare. And with the active participation of the lady. Kaya sabi ni St. John Paul II, we priests have been consecrated in the church for this specific ministry. We are called in various ways of contribution where our providence puts us to the formation of the community, to the people, and our task is to defend the flock God entrusted to us. That is why we can St. John Paul II, his pastoralist faculties, are first of us as the servant of the community. Of course, this reflects the physiology of the community. The church is communion, but the priest, the priest is not the servant of the community. But because in union with the bishop, and most related to the presbytery, it builds up the unity of the church community in the harmony of diverse vocations, charisms, and services. The ecclesiology of communion becomes decisive for understanding the identity of the priest. Its essential dignity and its vocation among the people of God. So this is what John Paul II emphasizes. The ecclesiology of communion becomes decisive for understanding the identity of the priest, which is essential dignity and its vocation among the people of God. To take note that what has developed since the Vatican Council is a very rich understanding of the priesthood. It is very broad. We are not defined by just our presiding, saying mass, or like our preaching. It's more than that. Pastoral role is even well. And that is why the priest must also develop communion among the members of the lay organizations within the church. And the priest is an advisor members to activate their participation in the respective PPCs. So a servant of communion, the priest has the responsibility to unite and coordinate all the various communities and groups within the parish. So yan ang nagsasabi na ang parita ay parang protocol sa orkestra. Daming mga instruments, di ba? Violin, viola, trumpet. But how can they play as one? And that is the role of the priest to make them, let them play as a one. The BBCs, the faith communities, the Thomas, the group, the Christian communion is completely expressed in the sharing of spiritual material and human resources. You don't tell me that you need that. And the role of the priest is to ensure that this communion of goods is practice at the parish and the BBC levels. And this is a big challenge. Finally, other alternative to the so-called Arantzal system, which has been a reputation of commercialization of the sacraments of this cafe, characterization, pero yan ang nangyayari. So the priest will encourage his parishioners and the BECs to share their time, their talent, and the treasure and a modified title that we introduce and we replace the Arantzal system in time. Parang the modified title does not mean 10%. Kasi it's a legacy of voluntary place. How much each family is willing to contribute monthly? Yung iba is public eh. Siya nag-pledge. Eh kung ikaw nakikita mo, kahit pesos lang ang ilagay mo, minsan mapahiya ka. Kaya yung recourse naman eh, kasi yung pag mag-alay, bakit ito, marami kayong kita, bakit yan yan lang ang nabibigay mo? But it creates a sense of, yun, ekonomiya, diba? We share, we support one another. This can only happen when a generous spirit of communion is fostered, accompanied by spirituality of stewardship and a system of transparency and accountability. And this is required when we become more transparent, di ba? Now we have talagang ganun to report, magkano talaga pumapasok at saka magkano ang lumalabas, and how much are you spending or sa iba-iba ng mga expenditure, whether it's the program of the parish, the personal and active of the sa parokya, at iba-iba pa. You know, the ministry of communion at sa pastoral care, shepherds in the midst of their flock. So ito ang kinakailangan whenever we exercise a ministry of pastoral leadership and communion, now we become shepherds living with the smell of the sheep, shepherds in the midst of their flock. And that is why the priest should promote ecclesia communion in the parish to form BECs and build up the parish as communion of communities or BECs. And this communion requires the priest is united to his flock to know the sheep. He develops closer relationship with the members of the parish community and the BECs, and this means becoming a good shepherd with the smell of the sheep. Kung palagi natin marapit sa mga tao with the sheep, of course you don't smell like them. Of course, doesn't mean that it's not illegal. But it simply means closeness. No? It's not a really smell, but or being close with them. So this requires knowing them, becoming close to them, and spending more time with them and developing friendship with them. The church, according to Vatican II and PCP2, is called to be a participatory church. And the BECs are an expression of this participatory nature from the church. And that is why the priest must enable the lay faithful in the parish and the means to actively participate in the life and mission of the church. And ito talaga ang malaking papel. Participatory. And this requires enabling the lay faithful to actively condition of the person and the decisions that affect them. And this means that he has to listen to them. Ang pakikinig sa kanila. Encourage them to participate in the process of decision making, planning, and implementation. And that is why that we have pastoral councils. These are instruments of lay participation in parish, ang mga parish assemblies. In exercising this leadership, it's important that they avoid an authoritarian and dictatorial style of leadership. You know, Arundo says that the ultimate authority in the parish is the parish priest. Of course, he's accountable to the bishop. And we have not abolished the institutional patriarchal model of the church. Tama yan, di ba? And even the PPC is an advisory consultative body. It is not an alternative center of power, di ba? And even Carmo says that the priest is the one that presides over the PPC. Kaya nga, kaya kailangan president ng PPC kasi the one that presides is the parish priest. That is given. But the way he exercises his authority should not be like a dictator, di ba? Kahit you can have the last say. What is very important because you're the ultimate authority, you're ultimately in charge of the parish, it's not too busy, but still requires a listening attitude, participation, meron na consultation. And the priest seems not as king of the parish, but the servant leader of the community and the PPCs. And this is why that to avoid the extremes, di ba? An extreme of authoritarianism and the extreme of liberalism. As if the priest is just one more. At sinabos mo na magunan ang decision sa karamihan. So how do you balance that? So this requires a more participative and collaborative style of leadership. Because you do not govern alone. You do not minister alone. There are other priests there and there are other lay people there in the palace that you need to work as a team. Okay, the prophetic ministry. The prophetic ministry exercised by the priest leads to the formation and growth of the PPCs as prophetic communities. It is the core of the prophetic ministry of the word. And that evangelization is an essential part of the formation of basic ecclesial communities. And the primary agent of this evangelization is a priest in collaboration with a people. Kasi the prophetic ministry is not simply just preaching in the Mass. Of course, that is the regular expression to preach and to touch the minds and hearts of people and to lead them to conversion. But it's not the only expression because there's still that whole area of an evangelization program for the parish. And that was BCs. Because you cannot form BCs without a solid evangelization program. The prophetic ministry would be incomplete without the exercise of the prophetic criticism of existing evil and sinful structures in society. And this requires the priesthood that becomes a conscience of society. Alam mo ninyo, in the Old Testament, the role of the prophets has already been performed. To announce the good news and to denounce sin and evil in all their manifestation. Kaya nga po, if you examine that, what is called the prophet, there is the so-called salvation oracles, di ba? It's good news. But there's also what is called the woe oracles. These are denunciation. Woe to you! Woe to you! At kayong tinitirahan talaga, yung mga abuses kasi those with power. And this is why that this is also applied to our own ministry as priests. Not just to announce and proclaim the good news, but to denounce existing evils in a society. And in order to carry this out, we have to read the signs of the times and analyze the contemporary situation, either the social, the economic, the political, the cultural, the environmental, and judge them in the light of the Word and of the Kingdom of God. And this is a very important task of our prophetic ministry. So this will require denouncing all forms of evil that we see in our society. We cannot be silent. Whether it is the injustice, oppression, the violation of human rights, ecological destruction, the culture of death, kasama na dito ang extrajudicial killings, the death penalty, guerra, and also the corruption that we find in our society. Thus, in our preaching, we cannot remain blind or silent in the face of these evils. Kaya nga, kung the recent cities of the state in Somalia, to be silent is to be complicit. Become accomplices of this evil in our society. And when we do this, we must be ready to face the consequence of our prophetic ministry. Rejection, suffering, and even death. It is often said that martyrdom is a consequence of the prophetic ministry. This was the fate of the prophets, this was the fate of Jesus, who faces the prophetic ministry. Sana ito mangyayari sa atin. But we must be prepared that if we take our prophetic ministry seriously, we must be ready to risk our lives. Especially when we are faced with a regime that supports us. A regime that cannot accept the decision. Our preaching of the word and the work of evangelization. The priest enables the people in a Christian community or diocese to actively participate in Christ's prophetic mission. Let us remember na ang propeta hindi lang tayo. It is the community itself that should be prophetic. And that is why the nature of we have a responsibility that the nature of the present commitment of the diocese as prophetic ministry is actualized. Hindi tayo dapat mag-iisa. Hindi pwede na ang pare, prophet, at saka ang kanyang mga community na nanonood lang. Wala na ginagawa. Because remember that they also share in Christ's prophetic mission. And it is our role. How do we animate and inspire them to become prophetic? And our parish, our diocese, needs to become more prophetic. PCP 2525, ito ang sinabi. The community over which the priest presides is also a prophetic community. The word is announced by the priest to the people, not only so that they gain themselves a life, or may be built into a community of believers, but in order that they may in turn become witnesses to the word they have believed. Peoples that have truly grown in their faith when they emerge as announcers of the word. To the servant leadership of the priest, the people of God are inspired and formed into evangelizing and prophetic community. They become an evangelizing and prophetic community. Ito ang malaking hamon. How do we turn our communities, lalo na with the formation of conscience. If there is no formation of conscience, if there are people who distinguish between right and wrong, what is good and evil, they can never emphasize specific things. And this is the danger I know in our Philippine society. The people become silent, not just because of fear, but because they no longer recognize what is right and wrong. What is good and evil? And they support evil. They think that what is happening for everything is okay, kahit ito yung Christian kids, kahit namin ang pinamatay niyan. The sacramental liturgical ministry, Vatican II anticipately asserts that the ministerial priesthood enables the people of God to actualize its common priesthood. Sabi ka nila, ano itong relation mo? Ano na life mo? Shared interest, priesthood, at saka tayo, ordained tayo. Ano itong relation dyan? It is our task to enable the people of God to actualize its common priesthood. And the task of the priest as leader of the priestly community is to foster full and active participation in the liturgical celebration. It's more than having beautiful and solemn liturgies with a perfect, with a perfect rubrics. The challenge is, what type of liturgies are we developing that will enable them the full and active participation? It becomes more meaningful, it becomes more festive. Yan po ang mahalaga, active participation kahit ang ating mga piyesta. I notice na part of tradition ng mga piyesta is may mga hermano mayor, hermana mayor. Sila lang ang yung mga may pera, sila ang naghahawak sa celebration of the piyesta, di ba? It becomes an affirmation of our social cultural structure that is patronage, di ba? Patron at saka elitist. If you want changes, it doesn't begin there. You have to challenge these forms. That the fiesta is a celebration of communion of the entire community. It must be an expression of koinonia, sharing ating fiesta. Kuhinig ito sa politiko, hindi ito sa mga mayayaman. And I think it's important that not just in our fiesta, but in our liturgies, na kahit ang ating mga minsan mga choir, di ba? Maganda ang mga choir, maraming voices yan, pero parang nag-concert. Walang participation ng mga tao. And, you know, it's so important that all our liturgies must be participative. It must be communitarian. It must be meaningful. Kasi yan ang essence sa sakrosantong konsilyo eh. It's like a refrain, full and active participation in our liturgical celebration. Kaya natin sa mga Eucharist, mga fiesta, kahit mga choir, mga singing, it must be participative. And it is the role of the priest to form the parish and bring his interest in worshiping and celebrating community. A worshiping and celebrating community. And the celebration is a celebration of the entire community presided by the priest. So in exercising sacramental and liturgical ministry, it's not enough that the priest administers the sacraments at the parish church. Yes, to go back and open to the barrios, the barangays. Then we don't need this to celebrate the Eucharist with a basis for the frequently, whether it's monthly or bi-monthly. Sa kala mo, we don't have to say, okay, parang papapay sa atin dyan, mag-ahanda kayo ng 1,000 or 2,000. You know, darating ang panahon ng tingin, if you don't tell them magkana susupra yan sa 1,000 or 2,000. Pero we should not make no money para lang Because once we create that spiritual stewardship, sobra na yan. Of course, pagsimula, minsan hirapot yan sa pagkasulina. But it's important that we have to create that whole atmosphere. I think that in agreeing ang mga sakramento. That whatever they share, there is koinonia talaga yan. Mga connections o mga offerings. Okay, pangapat, is the social ministry. This pastoral ministry involves animating the parish community and the diocese to actively participate in the social servant mission. Again, it is the role of enabling of animating the parish and the diocese that they become actively involved in a social and servant mission. And that is why that we need to challenge them to address the problems that they face. That is the poverty, the injustice, the armed conflict, the destruction of government, drug addiction, and extrajudicial killings. You know, we should avoid na tayo yung bigang Bisaya o Santa Claus. Bakit ay siya ang lumunta sa problema ng mga tao. Para bang nag-isayaling complex. Let us remember that in all of this, kailan ang active participation ng mga tao. You know, when we organize yung mga community sa PEC, kailan sa laging complex, it was merely a challenge sa kanila. Nagigitan na yung dance. Maubos na natin mga watershed. We have affected already that question, ano gawin natin dito? You have to constantly ask, you have to constantly challenge them, and they say, oh, sabi na, people power. Kaya na yung mga, hindi ko umubra yung mga petition sa Presidente Correo. Kaya na yung dumating, parang, it was really a human barricade against lagging tracks. And we were ready for that. After that, then the process, the first Bible sharing, tulad simula sa Bible sharing. Coming to this mga liturgies, mga readings, pag-usapan ng mga issues about care for the earth, about how it affects the effect of the ecological destruction sa ating pamumuhay and on our task. Now, the prayers that they did sa mga classical sharing, kami doon ang mga study ng always meron ang participation na dyan. Yung sa pagkabato, that results, yan din ang challenge sa kanilang hari, si Monsignor Rocky. Kasi reklamo ng tao, ate, pero palagi na may baklit ng baklit pagdating sa kapatiro ko ng conflict. Kaya, that question, while the people were in the question, the first they were asked, what do you want to do? What are you doing? And that is the concept of peace zones emerge. It started with just a mass position sa area and established the peace zones. Lately, ngayon, it's already the question about yung mga drug addiction. Ano ito magagawa natin to address this problem of drug addiction para hindi masabi sa pagkakaroon at sa nasabi sa dunisan? So besides the monitoring and protesting against the killings, what is emerging is a sort of community-based rehabilitation programs. Marami na nagsisimula na ngayon sa Archdiocese of Pato, na we have an agreement with your place. Sa kapag-agreement, so walang pataya. And we are going to work together para to address the problem of drug addiction. So in that area, sa tulong pa sa tanawan na dating, no killings. And what we have is community-based rehabilitation programs. So, you know, all of these things, looking for alternatives, the same time negotiating. Kung meron ng patayan, then talaga ang protest to expose the killings. So the priest should initiate and support programs that respond to the needs of the people. Initiate support programs that respond to the needs of the people. You should encourage and support the diocese to work for justice, peace development, and integrity of creation, and help transform society. Yan talaga ang maraming na. You know, in exercising this ministry of social concern, the priest should avoid becoming subservient to ideologies, political parties, and politicians. Because we find ourselves in a field na maraming actors, whether it is mga underground, mga ideal movements, or mga political parties, or mga politiko. And the question is, how do we relate to them? First, it must be important that we have to avoid being so certain to them. It has happened during martial law, sinasakyan ng mga program na simbahan, either from left or from the right. At saka ngayon, iba na, they think that the way to proceed is na, again, to relax on the dangerous politics, naging tao ni gobernador o ni sinamayan. So we should maintain autonomy and independence from this or at the same time, conducting dialogue with them. And lead to dialogue. The motivation and dynamism in a social apostolate spring from our faith and mission and not from our ideologies. Okay, ministry to the poor. The ordained ministry is understood and lived in the context of what the church is called to be. At alam naman natin namin in the Philippines and of course with the Pope Francis, na there is a lot of emphasis on the church of the poor. And with this vision of the church, that becomes part of our ministry. The priest plays a vital role in making this vision of the church, which is the poor, a reality. And it is the duty of the priest to see that the church really becomes a church of the poor, especially in the parish and the PECs. We must see that the church really becomes a church of the poor. This means being the first to embrace evangelical poverty. You know, this is not just about some mga religious. And in this video, we really nakikita na dyan na this is something that we ourselves must embrace. But what does evangelical poverty mean? It essentially means to put our trust not in riches but to rely in God's providence. That is the essence of the poverty in spirit. Ang Diyos lang ang ating yaman, and to trust in God, not in power, not in iba. And this means developing a spirituality of stewardship. That we are not the owners of the diocese and the palace and its resources, but simply the stewards. Alam mo, there's a temptation with